Hi everyone, welcome to Heaven Healing and Tarot. This is Christina, and today's pick a card is Are They the One? I had to think about it for a minute. Are they the one? So we're going to have somebody in mind that we want to know if they're the one for us. Are they the one that we should be with? Before I get started, I always send out some healing. So take a deep breath with me. All right, pile one, white, pile two, purple, pile three, peach. Take a moment, pick the pile you are most drawn to, and we'll see if the person you're thinking of is the one for you. All right, pile one, let's see if you choose white, see if your person is the one for you. Here we go. Uh-oh, five of pentacles. The world, the moon, oh, the sun, and the Knight of Pentacles. All right, so this is what I'm getting. I'm getting like this is somebody who either broke your heart or you broke theirs. But it looks like there could be a new beginning here. We could be putting that chapter to rest and starting a new one. Or it could be somebody who's getting out of a relationship and wanting to start a new one. So it just depends. If this person didn't break your heart, if you guys didn't break up at some point in your life, then this is somebody who recently got out of a relationship and is feeling alone in the world and sad and ready for somebody new. But they also have, like, they're also confused. You know, the moon is like, not seeing very clearly, not exactly knowing what to do, not knowing how to move on. If this is somebody that you were in a relationship with in the past, again, the confusion could be like, is it going to work this time? Should I give it a chance? I don't know. So there is a little bit of confusion about not knowing what's going to happen or how things will play out. But look at that sun. That tells you everything. That tells you after the time of darkness, the light will be there for you. The light will shine. So the sun tells you that this time or this person, you guys could be so happy together. So is this person the one? I absolutely think so. I just don't think it's going to happen very quickly. The Knight of Pentacles is the slowest knight in the deck. He's going to take his time. Male or female, doesn't matter. I say he because it's a knight. Anyway, they're going to take their time. So this isn't something that's going to develop overnight. This is something that's going to develop over time. So just know that. But I absolutely think this could be the one for you. It's actually kind of exciting. Let's see what else comes out. Successful outcomes to your problems. You've got the key to success. And involvement with the law. Look at that gavel. Well, I'm not taking that as anything negative. The gavel, I mean. It could be somebody who had some trouble with the law, but I'm not going there. I don't really feel that so much. I feel like that could be like a legal commitment. Or, you know, this could be they got divorced and they've been alone, you know, and sad over it. Sad over not having, a marriage. Or it could be very positive where they're seeing a future with you. They're seeing a commitment, a marriage in the future. So some kind of, or... It doesn't necessarily have to be marriage, but it could be signing contracts. Like, you know, it could be like moving in together, signing a lease together, you know, buying a house together, some kind of legal paperwork coming in with this person. So if this is, you know, somebody who wants to be with you, they're looking ahead. They're definitely looking ahead, which is saying that you guys have a future, you know, if you want to. Or it could be, like, again, somebody just getting out of a marriage, breaking a contract. So you take it how it resonates, but you know, depending on who you picked as your person for this pile, I still think that they're the one. I think you could be so happy with this person. But things could be up in the air, like not knowing exactly if it's going to work or not. And that's okay. But I think in the long run, it will. New career. Did somebody recently get a new career, which then changed their energy? Which is might be allowing this energy to come in now. Somebody has a new career. It brings in new things, new chapters in your life. So if somebody has a new job, then this is saying that new job spurred this energy that is allowing you guys to make a go of it. If that's not the case, then I just feel like this is a new start for you guys. Right? This is kind of a love reading. It's not, it doesn't really have anything to do with money. So we can just take that card and have it resonate as far as it's going to be a new beginning here, a fresh start with you guys. Oh, it's got your spirit guides are guiding. Oh, your spirit guides are going to make this happen. That's nice. That's nice to know that you're supported from the other side. This relationship, like this connection, they want you guys to be together. Nurturing. Yeah, there's going to be love here. There's definitely going to be love here. You guys are going to be very loving and nurturing towards each other. It almost feels like someone wants to take care of the other. Someone wants to be the, you know, let me take care of you. I got you type of energy, which is so attractive, I think. The miracle of forgiveness. So, okay, so that's talking about the sadness. So once this person forgives, whether it be you or you forgive them or somebody else that, you know, like I said, that they ended it with, that again allows them to move on. Forgiveness is the key to success. If you guys can forgive each other, or if they can forgive you, you could forgive them. Again, it will lead to happiness. So that card is a beautiful card to get. Clear out the clutter. So I think this is like in your head. Stop thinking the worst. The confusion, the moon. You know, sometimes we can self-sabotage by thinking things can't work out or things will never happen, you know. Oh, it'll never happen like that. It won't happen like that. Don't do that. Clear out all that negative thinking, all that clutter, all that, you know, fear talking in your head. Stay positive. Have an open mind. You know, and if you can't stay positive and if you can't think positive things, then don't think anything at all. A blank mind is better than a negative mind. You know, like just say, I give it up to God. I give it up to Source. Universe, take the wheel. You guys, if this is meant to be, it'll be. And leave it at that. Don't self-sabotage here by thinking negative. Clear out the clutter. For some of you, I want you to clear out the clutter in your home. Sometimes when there's an easy pathway for energy to find you, for energy to flow, again, it changes the energy of things. So if you guys have clutter in your house, it's holiday time, you might have more clutter than normal, but do your best and clear out any clutter in your living space. Emotions are running high. That means that they're really thinking about you or you're really thinking about them. You're excited about this. You're excited about possibilities. That's great. Again, it's motivation, right? Six of Air, which is Six of Swords. Moving on to better pastures here. Let's see.
Where is my book?
I can't find it. Let's see what the book says. Let's read the blurb. There. Oh, just passed it. However turbulent the waters at the moment, I trust if I create calm within, my outer conditions will soon become too. I am conditioned to expect trouble ahead, but I have shifted my awareness and know that I can choose to believe that stepping into the unknown will bring me what I truly desire. I am in transition to something better. Your relationship's going to become something better, okay? Again, the unknown, being unclear, the fogginess with the moon, right? It's okay to not know what's going to happen as long as we clear out the clutter in our head, clear out the negative, you know, create the calm within us. This is beautiful. Don't think the worst, only think the best. And, you know, something amazing can happen. Something amazing could really, truly happen. Let's get a thoughts and feelings card. I know that the fire that burns in you is the same that burns in me. So they desire you as much as you desire them. Let's get some charms. All right, what do we got here? Don't hold on to anything negative. And don't hold on to this too tightly either. Let the universe do its work. Let this flow to you, all right? Don't hold on too tightly. But there's going to be love here, I think. I think things are changing. We're going to get out of that moon phase and come into the light. I need a sun. I have a moon charm. I don't have a sun charm. I need a sun charm. Luck is on your side, going in the right direction. A lot of abundance. Cupid. The month of June did come out as well. I don't know if it'll take till June, but yeah, because that's like 6 months away, right? Do we really want 6 months for this to happen? But again, they are the Knight of Pentacles, which does move pretty slow. But I don't know what June means, but that is what I have for you, pile one. So it's a big yes for me. But you always have to do what's best for you and decide for yourself. Give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment. All those things help me and I appreciate you for it. Till next time. Love and light. Hi, pile two. If you chose purple, then this one is for you. Let's get some cards. Queen of Wands. Knight of Cups. The Death card. Page of Swords. And Two of Cups. Like, I was like, oh, two great cards, right? And then Death card. Oh. But Death card is not a bad card, so. And then you got Two of Cups. Yes, this is a yes from me. This is exciting. Yeah, this person thinks of you as their soulmate. This is someone who is, like, thinking of a rebirth, because could this be somebody you knew at some point, and they're getting, like, another chance to be with you? It doesn't have to be an ex. It might not be somebody you were ever with. It could be somebody you used to know. Maybe somebody you used to work with or something, and, like, they're, like, they, like, if you bumped into somebody you recently haven't seen in a while, maybe, you're like, oh, here's a chance for a rebirth. I don't know. I'm not feeling like an XX. I'm not feeling that type of energy, but this person desires you, and they feel like it would be a wish come true to be with you. They feel like you could be a soulmate. I feel like they've learned something with you, or learned something about you recently. Could be somebody you work with, but, or go to school with, but I kind of feel like this is somebody who you, maybe you used to work with, or somebody you, I don't know. The rebirth feels like it's like a renewal here. I'm not really feeling death or ending, unless it's the ending of singlehood. I'm feeling rebirth here, like something's coming to life. I don't know exactly. We're going to get some more cards piled too, but I absolutely give this a thumbs up. Yes, I like this person. They desire you. So that's amazing. They think of you as a wish come true. How fun is that? Strong emotions, passionate or love or hate, but we're going with love. We're definitely going with love. Look at this Queen of Wands. They desire you big time. This is like cool. I don't know. I just like, oh, romance is in the air. I'm so giddy for you. I'm just so excited for you. I think this is amazing. This is so interesting to me. Like, I don't know why, but I love this. I absolutely love this. This person is going to be fun for you. If it has a really good feel to it. Moving. Well, something's moving on. Moving along, I should say, is what I meant to say. I don't know what moving is. Are you moving? Are you moving closer to this person? Are they moving closer to you? Are you moving in with them? I don't know. Are you making some kind of a move? Are you changing jobs? Huh. I don't know, but a move comes into play here somehow. Let's keep going. You're going to inspire them. What are you going to inspire them to? I feel like this is somebody that you have been in recent contact with somehow, some way, even if it was like you ran into an old friend or something, but you inspired them to, like, maybe you bumped into somebody and they're like, hey, Bio2's looking good. And you're inspiring them to, like, think about you and to maybe make a move. That's the energy it kind of feels like. Like, you're really inspiring them to take action. But it's still, like, up in the air. There's still a bit of mystery around this. Like maybe you're not even thinking that this is a possibility. Like, or maybe it's a mystery of how you would feel. Like, they're thinking, oh, I have no idea how they would feel about it. So it still feels like it's kind of up in the air, but it feels like it could be kind of amazing. They're seeing you as an earth angel, someone who, sorry for that little interruption, my son came in. Anyway, earth angel, they see you as an earth angel, like someone who, like, you're their inspiration. Like, they see you as someone who is, like, good and kind and loving and someone that they desire. Either that, or they want to be an angel to you and help you out in some way. Maybe they want to help you move. I don't know, but I kind of feel like they're seeing you as, like, this earth angel. I don't know. It's so interesting, though. Make your dreams real. Is that for you or for them? Like, somebody really desires the other. And it could be you because you're doing this reading on them, right? But you can make your dreams come true. This could be something. Work through your fears. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid of this. Take a shot with this one. Shoot your shot. The Hermit. Oh. They see you as somebody who has been out of reach. But now you're within their grasp. They feel like they can reach you now. Or you feel like you can reach them now. I think they're intrigued by you. I think that part of that mystery card is about them being, like, really curious about who you are and what makes you tick, and like, I don't know, peeling back your layers. Like, I feel like they're really intrigued by you. And that Hermit card does really make me feel like this is somebody that you haven't seen in a while, that you kind of like came back into contact with somehow. I don't know. Let's get a thoughts and feelings card. I want to be there for you to take care of you. Yeah, I do feel that. Oh, that earth angel. They want to be your angel. They want to help you. Ah. I do like this. I like this a lot. All right, here we go. What do we got? What have we got for charms? Angel. They want to be your angel. Let me be your angel. Did you ever hear that song? It's an old song by Stacy Ladisaw. I know, but any of my male viewers out there are probably like, what song is that? I'm hearing that in my head. Let me be your angel. Someone's smitten with you, or you're smitten with them. But you got the Wheel of Fortune here, so that's really good. They're saying step up, wear that crown, go for it. Your moon, this is the right direction. We got the moon again. So this is like moon mystery, things being like uncertain, not sure if this will work, being a little bit afraid to take a chance. Don't. This is going to take you by surprise, or you're going to take them by surprise, but it's a pleasant surprise. I think these feelings are like, oh, look, you did get the basketball. Shoot your shot. I did say that, right? I'm so excited. You should shoot your shot. This is a good one. I like this reading, and I like it for you. Yeah, you got the pencil. You get to write the next chapter with this person in it. Alright, pile two. I'm just like, I'm over the moon for this. I don't know why this one is like stirring me up, but this one's stirring me up. I guess maybe because it's all the passion or whatever, but I'm excited for you on this one. This one's gonna make you smile. Alright, I gotta end it. That's what I got for you. Give me a video, give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and leave me a comment, because it does help me, and I appreciate you. Till next time, love and light. All right, pile three. If you chose peach, then this one's your pile. Let's see what comes out. Ooh, seven of swords. Strength. Ooh, nine of swords. Ace of wands. And five of wands. All right, you are conflicted if this person's your person or not. Did they cheat? Did they lie? I feel like you're super attracted to this person. You have a lot of desire for them. You really want this to be your person, but you see the red flags. You definitely see them, but you're wanting it so badly that you're like almost ready to overlook those red flags. But deep down in your heart, you know that red flags are there for a reason. This one's driving you crazy because you're losing sleep over this. This is something you want. I'm here to say, I don't think this is the one for you. I don't think that this is something that you should hang your hat on. I just feels off. It just feels off. And I can feel you wanting it, you wanting me to say yes. And I just can't do it. Not from these cards. We'll pull some more to see if it changes. But if you got a cheater and a liar here, I'm telling you no. Absolutely not. If it's not a cheater or a liar, someone who's just maybe might be a little sneaky, then we'll see. But usually my gut's right. My gut right off the bat said no. Let's keep going. Oh, financial pinch, a new job or career. Oh, If this, oh, I hope this person's not using you for money. Pile three. Do not let anyone take advantage of you. Relationship dynamics. Yeah, I think the dynamics of this relationship are off. I think you feel it. I think it's uneven. I think it's unfair. And you know it. I'm not telling you anything you don't already know. There's a trust issue. There's a trust issue here. You're asking for assistance. You're asking for assistance. You're asking for this to change. You can't make someone change. You can't make someone feel what they don't feel, and you can't make someone do what they don't want to do. Thank you, Azriel, for leading me safely through this change. You need to make a change. You need to let this person go. They're not the one for you. I know. If this is not what you want to hear, I know how hard it is. And you always have to do what's best for you. So if you're telling me I'm dead wrong, then I'm dead wrong. But what I'm feeling from these cards is you need to make a change for the better. You need to let this person go. They're causing you too much anxiety, strife, stress, depression. You don't need it. And I think you see it. You see clearly. Like, I think you already, I don't think I'm telling you anything you don't already know. I just think that you're hoping for somebody to tell you something different. I can't do that. I'm not one of those readers. I will not sugarcoat things, and I will not tell you something that you just want to hear if I'm not feeling it. I'm so sorry. So sorry. But you and your loved one are safe without this person in your life. Like, you're safe. You'll be okay. You don't need this person. You got the Fool. This is you wanting to take a leap of faith. I know you want to take a leap of faith, but are you being a fool? I know I'm calling you out right now, and I'm sorry. I really am, because I know I've been in this position. I know exactly how this feels, so I get it. But you got to do what's best for you, and I can tell you what's best for you is to let this go, move on, find somebody new. But you gotta follow your heart and do it. Do whatever it is that makes you happy. But I don't see this person making you happy in the long run. So my answer is no. But as always, you do what's best for you. I'm gonna pull the Thoughts and Feelings card anyway. It's like we share the same heart and mind. That might be what they're telling you. I think they're telling you what you want to hear. Let's pull some charms. It's time for you to explore your options. You're at a crossroads, right? But you feel like this person's your soulmate, and this is where you want to be. But you got to be clever. You got to think outside the box. You got to be smart. You got to be the owl. Be the wise owl. See things clearly. See things clearly. You got luck on your side. You're learning something from this. You got the apple, and you got the apple teacher. So this is teaching you a lesson. So this relationship, or whatever this dynamic is, was meant for you because you're learning from it. But this person's hiding things. They're wearing a mask. They're hiding things. You got August. I don't know what that means, but you got August. Anyway, pile three. I know this is a tough one to hear, especially if you were hoping for it to go the other way. I have to give this a no. But as always, you do what's best for you. And do me a favor and like the video anyway and leave me a comment. Even if it's to curse me out, go ahead. I give you permission. Christina, you don't know what you're talking about. This is my person. And that's okay. I will accept it. I will accept how you feel. I'm so sorry. All right, give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, leave me a comment. All those things help me, and I do appreciate you, even if I tell you bad news. Till next time, love and light. Much love to you, Pile 3. Much love.